At 160 pounds with two undefeated fighters, we take a look at the corona tail of the tape for Hugo Centeno Jr. and Maciej Sulecki. Centeno Jr. 24-0 with 12 knockouts. Sulecki 22-0. Fanfara has the advantages in height and, Hugo Centeno Jr. rather has the significant reach advantage in this one, 74 inches to 68 inches. Both fighters about 6 foot one. Let's go right now to arena announcer Ray Flores.
Ladies and gentlemen, live on NBC from Chicago, Premier Boxing Champions now features 10 rounds in the middleweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, wearing the red and the white. He enters the ring undefeated, 22 wins, 7 of those coming by way of knockout against no losses. Fighting out of Warsaw, Poland. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Maciej Sulecki. And across the ring, his opponent fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the United States and the Mexican flag. As a professional, he's perfect. 24 bouts, 24 victories, including a dozen wins coming by way of KO. Fighting out of Oxnard, California. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Hugo, the Boss, Centeno Jr.
And your referee in charge, Mark Nelson.
As earlier, you both know what I expect. Please give me a good, hard, clean fight, obey my commands, and protect yourself at all times. Touch them up.
Well, guys, to this point, it has not been a good night for fighters out of the area of Warsaw, Poland. And here is Maciej Sulecki, a 27-year-old from Warsaw, 22-0-7 by knockout after coming up with just 3 knockouts his first 18 fights. He's now knocked out his last 4, and he's going up against Hugo Centeno Jr. from Oxnard, California. And his last fight, 10-round unanimous decision over Josue Ovando last December, a surprising struggle for Centeno, a closer than expected 10 rounds. And BJ, we talked about it with him yesterday. He says he was actually affected by Ovando's height. He was expecting to fight someone 5'11". He said the guy comes in 6'3", 6'4". Nice scouting. How do you not know that?
You got to fire the guy, whoever turned in the scouting report, Mar. It wasn't a good job. You know, look, at this level in boxing, you got to do your research. You got to do your homework. And he was surprised, and he fought accordingly. The guy fought him well, and he wasn't prepared for it. But tonight, he says he's focused. He knows a lot about this kid, and he's looking to put on a great performance to make people forget about his last performance.
Break. Sulecki looks to be the most dangerous opponent that Centeno has ever faced. 3-time Polish junior champion as an amateur. Made his pro debut at the age of 21.
And something I really like about Sulecki, Marv, is that, you know, his big amateur background. He had a lot of amateur fights, and it's hard to be a good champion when you weren't a good amateur.
Marv Albert, BJ Flores, welterweight contender Errol Spence.
Speaking of guys with great amateur careers, Errol Spence, quite a few multiple national titles, Olympian for Team USA. What do you see so far in the first round, Errol?
I like what Sulecki's doing. He's using his jab. Centeno trying to use angle, trying to box him, and trying to catch each other's rhythm in the first round, which is perfect.
These are middleweights that are scheduled for 10. Sulecki, after coming up with only 3 knockouts his first 18 fights,
stop.
As I mentioned, come on in that department.
No knockout.
No fighter from Poland has ever won a world title at middleweight.
Yeah, they've had some really good light heavyweights. Some good heavyweights. Andrew Galata and Thomas Adamek, Andrzej Fanfara also. So, a lot of good tradition for fighters from Poland, and this guy's trying to, continue with that tradition.
Well, how about Joseph Smith at 232 of round 1? with the knockout of Funcala. This is a quarter look-in brought to you by Applebee's. On to round two. Maciej Sulecki and the white red trunks.
Pretty even fight so far.
Yeah, close first round there, and you see Sulecki, he talked about, you know, wanting to get that left jab going, wanting to mix it up and offset Centeno with his left jab to set up his combinations. Neither guy has really gotten into too much of a rhythm yet, so it's going to be interesting over these next couple rounds to see who dictates the terms of the fight. Who makes the other guy fight his game plan, because I believe that's going to be the key for either fighter tonight.
Definitely, it's a battle of the jabs right now. Centeno's on a, throwing a nice counter hook, though.
When, keep your head up. Be careful, guys.
When Sulecki comes in.
Standing kind of straight up, though, on the inside, Arrow. And, you know, it could be very dangerous when you're on the inside and you're a tall guy anyways to stand straight up. So you've got to make sure and bend those knees, get his head off to one side or the other.
I have a question for Arrow coming off what was a dominant fifth round knockout with Chris Algieri in mid-April. What is next for you?
I'm fighting August 21st on NBC.
And you'll be fighting who?
That's in the works now, but it will be
in the works. The old in the works.
TBA.
But it will be a title eliminator for the IBF.
Well, that's fantastic.
Get out of there. Punch out. Get your hands free.
You know, great win on your last fight, Earl, in April. I had an opportunity to cover that fight. You know, Chris Algieri, a very good fighter, someone we've seen in with top opposition and always performed very well. So, you know, for you to go in there and make a statement like that, taking nothing away from Chris, but it was just a great performance by you. And complete body attack, nice transformation in your career and your style of fighting over the last, 12 to 18 months. I've seen some real changes in you, and you're doing some really good stuff.
Thank you.
And whoever that mystery opponent might be. So if you are victorious, it could mean a mandatory challenge for a welterweight title.
Yes, August 21st will be the mandatory challenge. So hopefully I get Kell Brook next.
That's down the road.
Down the road.
And Sulecki's having some good moments here in round two, Marv. He backs Centeno up in the corner and landed some good shots. He's in the clinches. He's trying to fight. He's really he didn't come in to lose tonight. Wants to keep that undefeated record.
Stop. So two rounds in the books. Maciej Sulecki, 27 years old, out of Warsaw, Poland, going up against Hugo Centeno Jr., 25-year-old, out of Oxnard, California.
Heating up a little bit.
Centeno, Marv, just caught Sulecki with a nice right uppercut and stunned him a little bit. Good shot.
Official scoring of Eric Raskin. Sulecki ahead after winning the first two rounds.
Stop.
Sorry. Nice counter left hook by Sulecki a second ago. He's looking to time the left jab of Centeno and slide on the inside of it, Marvin. Hit him with that left hook, get close, and then do work. Nice left hook again.
Yeah.
left hook to the body definitely got the attention of Sulecki there. You saw Errol, you know, a lot of guys don't like to shoot lead left hooks, but Centeno did it a second ago, and it landed nicely to the body.
Yeah, it's working for him. He's tall, he's rangy, and the left hook worked for him. You see Sulecki backed up after he hit him with a body shot.
And a good right hand by Sulecki.
You know, body work does so many things. It, you know, keeps your opponent more defensive. It takes the stamina and the energy out of him. It also makes them, you know, be less offensive. Body work is so important. And, you know, look at some of the good body punchers of years past. Julio Cesar Chavez, you know, guys like that, how they're able to take their opponents apart. It's nice to see a young prospect like you that's got such a belief in body punching. Have you always fought like that, or is that something you tried to develop since you've been a professional?
It's something we develop. It's something we develop in amateurs. And it's something I've been using for the longest.
I think the hand speed and the foot movement of Sulecki's, you know, causing Centeno a little bit of problems here, Marv. He's really able to, you know, Sentinel's not completely comfortable with what's going on right now, and that's because of that left jab and that movement of Sulecki.
And Centeno has sparred with several quality fighters. This one, Provodnikov and Peter Quillett, Triple G, Sergio Martinez.
Hands free.
Has been knocked down once. Back in 2013, Centeno behind on points, and he came back to stop Osuo in round 10.
Nice. Good right hand from Sulecki.
On the scorecard of our unofficial score, boxing writer Eric Raskin, it's 3-0 in favor of Maciej Sulecki. 20-18 over the first three rounds. Scheduled for 10. These are middleweights. And here now, the unofficial scorecard from Eric, brought to you by Mobile Strike. And it looks to be a unanimous to this point for Sulecki.
Yeah, having a shutout, Marv. 3 rounds to nothing, 30-27. What's impressing me with Sulecki, he's got the better techniques, shorter, sharper, straighter punches, nice counter punching. It's pretty much a one-sided, surprisingly one-sided fight, I should say, so far, because this looked really even on paper going in. But so far, Sulecki out to the early lead.
And I like what Eric said. You know, it's been surprisingly one-sided. Why is that? Because of the left jab and the left hand of Sulecki. He's got that punch going, and it's really thrown Centeno off.
Now let's go over to Kenny Rice. Kenny.
All right, thanks, Marv. In the Centeno corner with Eric Brown. Eric, what do you think so far?
I think we're doing okay. I just want Hugo to be a little bit busier, that's all. This kid's tough. He's a busy guy. But I like what Hugo's doing. I just want him to do a little bit more.
What does he have to do more, you think, to take charge here?
Just stay on top of his game, keep working his jab, keep counter-punching this guy, and putting combinations together. All right, come on, work!
All right, thanks, Eric.
Eric Brown in the corner of Hugo Centeno. He also trains, Eric does, former middleweight champ Peter Quillett.
Eric Brown was an assistant of Freddie Roach for a lot of years and learned a lot of good stuff at that wild card gym out there. He's got a nice stable of fighters now, and he's going to have to tell Centeno something to get him going here, because so far he's having some troubles with the style of Sulecki.
Maciej Sulecki is the crowd favorite by way of Warsaw, Poland, a crowd that is not happy with what they saw from Warsaw's Andrew Fanfara, who was knocked out in the first round by Joe Smith Jr.
A shocking performance by Joe Smith Jr. in the last fight. You know, Fanfara comes in as a huge, huge favorite and gets floored early. But gotta remember, this is boxing.
And Fanfara, as we mentioned earlier, considered among the top 4 or 5 light heavyweights in the world.
That's why that division is so exciting. New face is coming in all the time.
All right, final seconds of the fourth.
We see some good action, you know, talking about some of the scoring, how it's gone so far. You see Centeno land a nice overhand right. Sulecki coming back with a nice right-hand counter.
Together a little bit more, Hugo, all right? You know, you seeing what this guy's bringing, and you making him miss real good, but you got to come up working, son, all right?
A corner looking brought to you by Applebee's. It is on to round five. It has been all Maciej Sulecki in the white and red trunks.
Yeah, Centeno's having a lot of problems, Marv, with that style. Errol, what are you seeing so far, you know, in the last few rounds? What does Centeno need to do to get going here?
I think he needs to stop falling in. He's falling in. Need to use his reach, use his jab, and come on the top with his right hand. Sulecki, he's fighting very smart, using angles, using his jab, countering Centeno, and looking good so far.
Yeah, he's doing some good work. You know, Centeno's a big... you know, undefeated guy. He's got way more knockouts, but sometimes records can be very deceiving. You got a guy with 150 amateur fights like Sulecki goes in there and just makes it look easy. And I think one of the main things Centeno has to do is take away the left jab of Sulecki. He's able to do it. He's able to land all these big punches, but he could take the left jab away by countering it with his own right hand. He could slip on the inside and hit it with counter combinations, anything to make him put that punch away, because so far it's controlling the fight, Errol.
Yeah, BJ. Sulecki, he's boxing now. He's actually moving around, moving backwards and using the jab and picking his shots. And countering with a nice hook.
He's really applying a lot of tempo and a lot of pressure to Centeno, to be honest with you. He's really taking control of this fight so far.
Centeno has not been active. This is his first fight this year. Had only a total of four fights the previous 2 years, which is not a busy schedule when you're talking about someone who feels he's a prospect.
Stop.
Right.
And, you know, he was looking for these types of fights, though, Marv. He said, you know, I want to fight good guys, good opposition. But so far, it's Sulecki who's really just in the driver's seat.
And it appears that Centeno has a cut on his right eye.
Stop! Break, don't punch.
And if I'm Sulecki here, Sulecki, I'm just going to keep doing exactly what I'm doing until Centeno makes me change up my game plan. I'm going to stab that jab into his body. I'm going to bring it back up top, hit him with the right hand, and take a little step to either side and make him find me again.
Centeno looks like he's getting a little discouraged.
Sulecki doing a lot of good punching in there, Marv.
And we've come to the end of round five.
We'll take a look at how Centeno got that cut on the right side of his eye. Nice counter left hook by Sulecki in that last round. Good counter punching by him.
And it appears that Maciej Sulecki is throwing a shutout as we get underway here in round six. Sulecki's last fight in January at Barclays Center in Brooklyn. He's got Derek Finley in the seventh round. The other card of a Deontay Wilder bout.
And Derek Finley, a tough but kind of a journeyman type level fighter. And, you know, sometimes you just don't have the right opportunities to show how good you are. And that might be the case with Sulecki. No big names on his resume yet, but after tonight, if he continues to do what he's doing, people are going to take notice of this kid in the middleweight division. I'm not proclaiming him to be the next entry on the pound-for-pound list, but I think he's doing a lot of good stuff tonight, and he's going to open a lot of eyes with his performance over a good undefeated young fighter.
Definitely. Great showing tonight. Showing a lot of skills.
Why is it a good showing here? What's he doing that's impressed you so far?
Just the way that he's coming at Centeno. Sometimes he jabs an inside. Sometimes he comes with the hook. He's countering. He's using angles. He's just varying up his punches, too.
It seems like he has an answer for everything that Centeno's trying to do. So I like that, and I got to attribute that to his vast amateur background.
And most of Sulecki's fights have taken place in Poland. And the Chicago with an enormous Polish population. You can hear the crowd rooting for Sulecki.
He's
right from the start.
Down.
Well, he might as well be in Poland tonight, Marv, because in Chicago they got a lot of fans that really support the Polish fighters. And, you know, they should be very excited about what they're seeing because, you know, like Errol said, he's really starting to break them down against the ropes with the body shots, the long shots on the outside. And Centeno's definitely frustrated. Punches are slowing down. He's starting to look a little, little winded. Sulecki getting a little careless there, kind of just jumping in with the left hook. He saw his left leg actually come up off the ground. But Centeno is in no position to make him pay.
Good combination by Sulecki. He was frustrated a moment ago by being tied up.
Well, I see Sulecki keep using the jab. He's going away from the jab a little bit.
I feel like he's able to walk. He feels like he's able to walk right into range and you know, land whatever he wants on Centeno. So.
Don't hold.
Holding
keep
and
your
hitting
head up,
our
man.
Partner
okay.
Sulecki as this sixth round comes to a close.
Continues tonight at 11 Eastern on NBCSN. As the action continues, I'm curious what Errol thinks of that upcoming bout between Thurman and Porter.
It's a great fight. This is what boxing is not about. Two young guys on the top of the game fighting each other, and that's what we need in boxing.
Well, that's not what we want to hear, man. Who do you want to win and who do you want to fight?
Very political, man.
Well, I don't care who wins, and I'll fight either one.
Anybody in specific that you dislike or like more?
I like Sean more. Sean, he's a humble guy, soft-spoken.
Way up, baby. Okay.
And I have more history with Sean through the amateurs and history with his dad, too. So I want Sean to win.
Centeno was just told to keep his punches up. Have you heard the reaction from the crowd this after a barrage thrown by Sulecki?
Good stuff. Sulecki's trying to take this out of the judge's hands here. He's going to say, you know what, I'm going to put an exclamation mark on an already good performance. And he came out blazing in the seventh round, Mark. A lot of punches and good combinations.
It appears to be a shutout as we check it with our unofficial scorer, Eric Raskin. How do you see it?
Yeah, I have it a shutout, Marv. 6 rounds to nothing, 60 to 54. Nothing's changed since the last time you checked in with me. Really, it's all Sulecki here. And I think Errol made an excellent observation a couple of rounds ago that Centeno is getting discouraged. I think that that's absolutely correct. And, you know, I don't know if he's got that extra gear, that motivation he needs to make any kind of comeback here. So far, we're not seeing it.
Yeah, Sulecki, Marv, looks like the stronger fighter and the more educated fighter. So when you got both of those things going your way and you're up 7-0 with only 10 rounds left, it's things are looking pretty good. You can have a good night. Nice straight right hand. And we're just not seeing enough offense from Centeno. He's just not doing enough to you know, be able to possibly give him any of these rounds on the scorecards. It's not even close.
And when you're down 6-7 rounds and you're really not a knockout puncher, very difficult here the rest of the way.
Oh, definitely. And his body posture just tells it all. He looked discouraged, looked like he don't want to be there now. And Sulecki's doing anything he wants to do in there right now.
Yeah, he's kind of starting to, you know, bully him around and beat him up a little bit. So, you know, first few rounds are close, but that left jab, such a separating tool and, you know, really good work.
Break, don't punch. Stop. Step back. Time.
Another round for Maciej Sulecki.
Looking here, the head of Centeno got a little low. Sulecki pushed the head down a lot of.
Oh!
He did get nailed.
We've seen that before. But
Whoa.
What a chin by the ref.
Is that Mark Nelson in there taking those punches? Look at him. He's got to wipe the perspiration off his face.
It is Mark Nelson out of Maplewood, Minnesota, showing that he has a very strong chin.
He's got a good chin, Mark. Look at that.
Look at Sulecki. He cannot believe it. That was the best punch of the fight by Centeno.
Mark Nelson looks like a former fighter himself. He took that well, Marv.
It is round 8 scheduled for 10. And it has been all Machets. Sulecki. Once again in the corner, there was blood from the right eye of Hugo Centeno Jr. Centeno actually began his career as a welterweight. It's only his fifth fight as a middleweight. His last five have been at this weight division.
Big right hand by Sulecki a second ago. Nice hook right hand combination. He's just punishing now. He's punishing Centeno against those ropes, Errol. What does he need to do to get his opponent out of here?
Well, I mean, he needs to work the body. I think he needs to work the body and come upstairs and come forward. Come forward with his hands up like he was trying to do in the beginning.
All right, once again, Kenny Rice.
All right, thanks, Marv. Sulecki corner, Chico Rivas. Anything you can tell him to do differently now?
Nah, he's listening to everything to a T, you know. We prepare everything for the right fight. And he's, you know, now we told him he's ready to go. He's putting power into his punches, trying to put it away. He's doing everything we asked him to do.
Is this about closing this fight out or just finishing strong?
Finishing strong. If the knockout comes, it comes. But if we finish strong, that's what we're looking for. Right? We're trying to bring the Polish people something that, you know, we just lost. But now we got a new Polish star coming up right now, and he's doing the right thing.
All right, thanks, Chico. Marv.
Kenny, Chico Rivas lives in Poland and comes to the United States to train Sulecki. And as he mentions, he's hoping that Sulecki, I don't think there's any question unless there's a surprise knockout here, bring some happiness to those who have turned up, who rooted for Andrew Fanfaro, who was taken down in the first round in a surprise by Joe Smith Jr. There's some pressure by Sulecki. We've had no knockdowns this round 8 scheduled for 10, but it has been a dominating performance.
And it just looks like a young kid against a man in there. It really does. Like, you know, Sulecki's able to do what he wants. He's controlling the fight. He's dominating, stronger, and he's really having his way with the undefeated Sentinel.
He's doing anything he wants in there, and I'd like to see Sulecki go for the knockout. He's on NBC. This is his showing.
Errol speaking on behalf of NBC. Earlier this evening, in a major surprise, you saw that big right hand by Joe Smith Jr. out of Long Island against the man known as the Polish Prince, who is also noted not to be a fast starter. And we saw that here tonight.
Those are things they told us yesterday in the fighter meetings. Barbie said, listen, you know, one thing I can do, I can punch. And one thing he doesn't do well, he doesn't defend when he punches. So I'm going to punch when he punches. That's exactly what he did, Marv, and got the biggest win of his career.
And as we mentioned earlier, Andrew Fanfaro, among the top 4 or 5 light heavyweights in the world, looking for another shot at Adonis Stevenson. His only loss over the last 20 fights in a light heavyweight title bout was to Stevenson 2 years ago in Montreal. He did knock Stevenson down in the 9th round, but Fanfaro was knocked out of the first round and the 5th, and Stevenson won it by unanimous decision.
It was a good fight. I remember the fight with big left hook by Sulecki a second ago. Centeno's hurt. and just a great win by Joe Smith Jr. I mean, he came in huge underdog and you know, turned the tides. He took control of his own destiny and scored the knockout. I'm not going to let the judges decide on this one. I'm going to take matters into my own hands.
And I can recall Fanfara telling us that he would not take Smith for granted.
I'm not so sure about that, Marv. I think they're so worried about that Adonis Stevenson payday. They're kind of overlooking, right, and they forgot they had Joe Smith in front of them tonight. Happens all the time. And it's human nature. It's almost impossible not to think about the bigger fight with Stevenson. Man, I can't. All I got to do is get by this guy, this guy, this guy.
Nice combination by Sulecki. But Centeno right on his feet. Sulecki's annoyed that it's lasted this long.
Yeah, he's definitely going for the knockout.
And now you see the blood of the nose of Centeno. Kind of a dangerous place when you're bleeding. Sometimes you've got a bad nosebleed. I know I've had it with come down my my throat and into my mouth before. So
was this in the ring or out?
In the ring. Yeah, but you see the blood of the nose. Makes it difficult to breathe. And then it also makes it you know, very uncomfortable for the fighter. He's already getting down.
Big right hand by Sulecki.
I think Centeno's showing. He's showing the chin.
Going home. Break it out of there.
Well, I'd like to see Merrill a little more willingness to fight from Centeno. Yeah. I know it's easier said than done, but you know, you got to give credit to Sulecki. Don't just say, hey, Centeno is he's not fighting. Sulecki's doing things to take away his offensive weapons.
Definitely.
Maybe you could take a page out of your manual on the body attack and see if you can get this kid out of here.
Tettle just looking to hang in to go the distance. 35 seconds remaining in round 9.
Yeah, I think Centeno, he's surviving now. I think he gave up.
And it's just strange you see that from a kid who's 25-0. So normally when you're 25-0, you want to go out on your shield or you're going to give it 100%. And, you know, it looks like that wasn't the case tonight.
So we are headed to the 10th and final round.
Sulecki is just having his way, doing whatever he wants with Centeno tonight, Marv. Very, very surprising how he's come in and been able to dominate. More good stuff from Sulecki.
All right, thank you, Liam. 10th and final round. Maciej Sulecki, Hugo Centeno. It has been a shutout. Sulecki, a 27-year-old out of Warsaw, Poland. 22-0. And Centeno, a 25-year-old out of Oxnard, California. Comes in undefeated. And as I mentioned earlier, Centeno has not been active as of late.
Six.
The first time that he has been knocked down.
Ready to go.
Second time in his career.
That's it.
And it's all over.
Great finish. That was a statement.
Hey, Early definitely made a statement, and I think it was the right call. You know, he was getting dominated all 10 rounds. Marv got hurt, got up. Referee took a good look at him, and he didn't look stable, so I agree with the call.
Mark Nelson saying that's enough. Maciej Sulecki making a lot of folks here happy after they saw that upside loss by Fanfara. Here's a combo, and back comes Sulecki with the right hand, and that's it.
And it was a good shot. Marvy set it up with a jab. He was getting in range for it all night. He landed it multiple times. Well, that time he landed it right on the button. Fight's over. I mean, they got to be ecstatic in the corner of Sulecki, like what they saw tonight. I mean, he boxed, he was effective, and he knocked this guy out. It's always nice to close the show in a fight that you're dominating in such a one-sided fashion.
And good to see Centeno up on his feet. Let's go to arena announcer Ray Flores.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee in charge, Mark Nelson, brings an end to the contest at 1 minute, 6 seconds of the 10th round. For your winner by technical knockout and remaining undefeated, Maciej Sulecki.
So Maciej Sulecki, fifth straight win by knockout. Let's take a look again. Looked like it was headed the distance, but one punch square to Centeno sends him down and says Centeno to the first defeat of his career and sends this crowd into a frenzy. It was disappointing for the Polish contingent when Fanfaro was defeated shockingly by knockout, but those who stayed around got to see Sulecki win by knockout here tonight in Chicago.